Okay, as we all know, this right here is the quadratic formula, and I'm pretty sure you have seen it before. But have you ever tried to integrate this? I don't think so. In fact, we differentiated this last year already. If you haven't seen that video, the link is in the description. Today, let's integrate this, and last year we did it with respect to a, today we'll do the same. So I'll put down integral and then dA. Feel free to try it with respect to b or c. And we'll just focus on the plus version. The minus version is pretty much identical. And this right here is perfect for calculus 2 students. Check this out. First, I will split the fractions. So we are looking at the integral negative b over 2a. And let me close that. And then for the second one, I will just write this down right here, plus, and I'll put it down in blue because this is the harder one. Integral of b squared minus 4ac over 2a in the a world. Let's finish this first. In the a world, a is the variable and then the rest are the constants. So negative b over 2a, you know, it's just constant multiple. Write that down first. And then integrating 1 over a in the a world, we get natural log absolute value of a. So done for the first part. Now, for the second part, how do we do it? Notice that we have the a inside of the square root and also a on the bottom. Let's just try to do it with a substitution. And because we have the square root, usually it's a good idea to let u equal to the square root part and hope for the best. And let's see, I'm just going to say u equal square root of b squared minus 4ac. And remember, we still have to get the dA. We have the a here. Let's isolate the a first. So I will square both sides, cancel this. I'll put this to the other side, put that back here. So we get 4ac equals b squared minus u squared, divide everybody by 4c. A equals b squared over 4c minus u squared over 4c. Now take the derivative. On the left-hand side, we get dA. On the right-hand side, what do we get from here? Just zero, because b and c are the constants. So the first part is zero. But we have to differentiate this. U is the variable. Put a 2 to the front, minus 1. 2 over 4, right? 1 half. So we have the negative u over 2, and also c is the constant. Leave it, and then attach the du over there. Now, with all that being done, we can take this integral to the u world. So we will get the integral. The top right here is our u over 2a. 2 is 2. A is that. So we have b squared over 4c minus u squared over 4c. And then multiply by dA, which is that. Negative u over 2c du. And this works out actually really well, to my surprise, because look, 2 times 2c is 4c, and then we have the 4c, 4c, so they cancel. So I'll just cancel this out for you guys. Then, of course, we can see that u times u is u squared. I will just have the integral u squared on the top. And then I'm going to use this negative to help me change the order of the subtraction. So I will write down u squared first, and then minus b squared, thanks to that negative. And then we are in the u world. Now, how do we continue? U squared, u squared. You can do long division to simplify it, or you can just go ahead, match the bottom by subtracting the minus b squared, and go ahead, just add it back. Yeah? The beauty of doing so is this over that is just 1. So we will have the integral of 1 in the u world first. And then next, b squared, I can put that down first. And then integrate 1 over u squared minus b squared in the u world. So this is just going to be u. Done. And now what's this? Well, this looks like the inverse tangent, right? Except for this is a minus. So in fact, we will get the inverse hyperbolic tangent. And let me just kind of put down the formula on the side to remind you guys. Note, if we have the integral of 1 over, let's say if we have u squared plus some number b squared, if this is plus b squared like this, this right here, we get the original inverse tangent, and you have to do 1 over b times the inverse tangent, original version, and then u over b, like this. And when you have a subtraction, be careful with that. If you have the integral 1 over u squared minus b squared, the structure is pretty similar, except for a few things, of course. First, if u goes first right here, the result is negative. So we have a negative right here. And then you still do 1 over b. And instead of inverse tangent, we will have inverse hyperbolic tangent. Inverse hyperbolic tangent. You read it backwards like this. And then inside is still the same. U over b and then plus c. So let's just use this. And ladies and gentlemen, we will just have plus b squared and then times that pretty much. So we will just write down negative 1 over b and then inverse hyperbolic tangent of u over b like this. And of course, this and that cancel, and then plus times negative, we can fix that. And I'm just going to put down the result right here. Ladies and gentlemen, this right here, we will first get u, which is that. So we are going to add square root of b squared minus 4ac. Then this and that, it's a minus. So let me just emphasize that. Be careful with the sign. Minus. We have b times the inverse hyperbolic tangent. Write it down backwards. And then u is that again. So square root of b squared minus 4ac over b. And yeah, that's it. And lastly, I'm not going to put down like plus c because we use c already. So I'll just put down plus k right here for the constant. So ladies and gentlemen, this right here is the result if you decided to integrate the quadratic formula with respect to a, right? By the way, this is also meant to be a constant. So perhaps I'll fix that to a k and a k. What do you guys think? That's it.